I love playing with Play-Doh.
Ah, shall I guess what they are?
You can.
Okay. I think this one might be a squashed dog.
No, it's a duck-billed platypus with two horns.
Really?
Yes.
A duck-billed platypus with two horns. Is there really a duck-billed platypus with two horns?
There is now. I can look at it. It's there.
But that's not real.
It is, because I've just made it. I make it, so therefore I can make whatever I want in any way I like it.
Fair enough. What about this? I've never seen a creature with a pink head and a green body. Let me guess. It's a cat.
No, it's a dog. A pink-headed, yellow-tailed dog.
Well, it's very cute. Okay. That looks like...
Well, it's unfinished.
Oh, good. I've just broken it. Go on, put it back together again. So what is it going to be?
I don't know. I haven't decided yet.
Well, surely you've got to make creatures that are real.
No. They're my creatures. I make them. As soon as I make them, they become real.
Okay. So they're your own creations, are they?
Yeah.
Ah, very good. Ha! It's an elephant, then.
If you say so.
Okay.
Here we go.
Oh, go on. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Welcome to 2021 and a new series of On the Sofa sessions.
Oh, can't wait.
God made everything right at the beginning, and he had the power to make everything just how he wanted it. Just like I could make my creations just how I wanted.
He certainly did. One day, when God had made the stars and the planets and the earth and the water, he decided to make people.
He took some dirt from the ground and shaped two people out of it. He breathed into them and they began to live.
You couldn't do that with your Play-Doh animals, but God could make things that were alive.
One of the people was a man and God called him Adam. The other was a woman and God called her Eve.
And that's not all. God made a place for Adam and Eve to live. It was the best sort of place that you could imagine.
For me, the best place I could imagine to live would be with views of a mountain and a gushing waterfall next to it.
I'd like to live near the sea, walking on the beach every day, hearing the waves lapping against the shoreline. Sounds idyllic.
For Adam and Eve, God made a garden for them to live in. There were all kinds of beautiful trees with all sorts of fruit, and the people could eat the fruit whenever they wanted.
I guess there were apples and oranges and pears as well. There was only one tree that they weren't allowed to eat from. We don't really know what the fruit looked like on that tree, but we know it looked really good.
God said, if you eat from that tree, you'll want to decide what's right and wrong for yourselves. But that's my job. If you eat from that tree, you'll forget that I'm your king, because I made you and I know what's best.
It was called the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. It was Adam and Eve's job to look after the garden for God. They were put in charge of it. It was God's special place. They even gave names to all the animals.
Adam and Eve lived happily in the garden together.
They were happy in the beautiful place God made them. And that is what our picture shows this week. God is king. He's ruling over the people he made in the beautiful garden.
I wonder what that perfect garden looked like.
I wonder how Adam and Eve felt in that perfect place.
I wonder what a perfect place would look like to you.
Today's song reminds us of what a wonderful world God made. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. Like much more than I never knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful.
Beautiful images of God's wonderful beautiful world. There was even your waterfall in your mountains.
Absolutely. We have such a wonderful world around us. We should thank God for it. Let's say a prayer for his beautiful world. Thank you, God, for this beautiful, amazing, intricate and wonderful world that you've made. Help us to care for it and show through our actions how precious it is to both you and to us. Amen.
Amen. Why not join us with our interactive Lord's Prayer?
When I touch my head, I think of you, Father God. When I put my hands over my heart, I remember to show you my love. When I put my hands together, I ask you to come and make everything right. When I touch my mouth, I ask you to give us the food we need. When I bow my head, I say sorry for the wrong things I've done. When I lift my head, I know you forgive me. When I open my arms, I ask you to help me be friends with everyone. Amen.
So what have we got next week?
Well, this is the first of 10 sessions where we're going to be looking at the big story of the Bible. Today we've been looking at how wonderful the world is. But next week, things take a turn for the worse.
Oh dear. I do hope we can make it right in the end.
Well, I know somebody who can. See you next time.
See you next time.